TrickBot is one of the prevalent malware families that we see nowadays. It has been active for about 3 years. We saw the first version in October 2016, and it is still being actively developed by the threat actors. It started as a banking trojan, but it has evolved into something much more than that. It has info stealing capabilities, it is like spyware, and it is also capable of installing a backdoor. The backdoor can then be used by other threat actors to intrude and to install other malware, such as the Rio ransomware. In the beginning, it was also targeting customers, but it has also like evolved, mainly targeting corporate networks nowadays. If a customer is infected by TrickBot, then it's not really obvious that he got infected by it, because that's exactly what the threat actors want. They want it to be stealthy, so that it remains invisible to the user, so they can so it can be active on the computer system as long as possible, so that the user doesn't know it. So how can a customer get infected by TrickBot? There are a couple of different infection vectors for this. One of them is spam email. In the past year, we have also seen that TrickBot is now also delivered to other malware. The future of TrickBot is that the malware as a service thing. So that is installing, or that it is providing some kind of framework for other threat actors so that they can access the victim system, or to install other modules from other threat actors. And I believe that TrickBot is not going away anytime soon, so that it is really here to stay.